Hello and welcome to TamoGraph Site Survey. In the previous video tours, we talked about how to conduct passive and active surveys using TamoGraph. In this tour, we'll talk about predictive surveys. Let's create a new project and give it a name. All we need at this point is a floor plan of the office where we plan to deploy our new Wi-Fi network. I've imported the floor plan image and a new project has been created. Now we need to calibrate the floor plan because the program is not aware of the map scale. This is easy. I just mark a certain distance on the map and enter its length. Then I type the length in meters and click apply. Unlike passive and active surveys that are based on actual on-site measurements, predictive surveys are intended for planning Wi-Fi networks that haven't been deployed yet. The Wi-Fi characteristics are predicted for the virtual environment model created by the user. This is called RF planning, and that's exactly what we're going to do now. To create a virtual model, I press the Show Hide Virtual Objects toolbar button. Now we need to tell the application about the position, size, and type of the physical objects that affect radio wave propagation. Typically, walls and other obstructions, such as elevator shafts, are already shown on the floor plans. However, these are merely lines and dots that are meaningless to the application. We need to draw these physical objects on top of the floor plan. I press the Wall Drawing Tool button and select one of the predefined wall types. I'm now drawing the walls on the floor plan. This process takes some time, so let's skip it and jump to the point where all the walls and obstructions have been drawn. Our virtual model is ready and we can place an access point for a quick test. A dual band AP has been placed. Now let's look at the resulting coverage in the 2.4 and 5 GHz bands. It's possible to group APs by band and by a few other parameters. As you can see, we obviously need more APs to provide high data rate connections in all areas, so I'm going to add more APs and experiment with their placement. It looks like 4 APs are sufficient to provide good coverage in both 2.4 and 5 GHz bands. I'm now checking signal levels in both bands, and high data rates are available everywhere. Now, if we look at the signal to interference ratio in the 2.4 GHz band, the picture doesn't look good. We see a lot of interference. Why? It's because we haven't planned channel usage properly. All the APs work on the same default channel, channel 1. Let's reconfigure them. As you can see, for each AP, I am setting a different channel in the 2.4 GHz band. I'm also setting the channel width to 20 MHz so that we could have 3 non-overlapping channels in the narrower 2.4 band. With a new channel plan, interference has considerably decreased. We can do the same with the 5 GHz radios. When you have verified that all the network parameters meet the requirements, you can start real-world deployment according to the plan. After deployment, you can use the same tool, TamoGraph Site Survey, for a post-installation survey to make sure that the network performs as expected. We have demonstrated only a small part of the predictive survey functionality. You can select custom antenna patterns, adjust AP data rates, work with multi-floor models, and more. You can also document your network design by generating customizable professional-looking illustrated reports in HTML or PDF formats. Be sure to visit our site and download the evaluation version. See for yourself how it can help you design wireless LANs. Also, feel free to contact our technical support. We'll be glad to answer all of your questions. Thanks for watching and goodbye.